What's up, you guys? It's your boy Pretty Boy Floyd here, man. And today's video, I just kind of want to go in a time lapse of just like what happens like from day one to like day seven when it comes to forehead Botox. So you guys know I go to Dr. Kato and Kato MD, get Botox in my forehead, of course, to prevent wrinkles. And if you don't know, man, like fine lines and wrinkles is like, it's a sign of aging, and it does not help out with like the way that you look. And in order to prevent that, you have to paralyze the muscles. And I've been over this in previous videos before, but you know, paralyzing the muscles to make them not move and to cause that wrinkling. And the neat thing about Botox is that if you are not too far gone, if you don't have really deep set wrinkles, and if you catch it early, those lines that you see at rest actually go away like within that week. And it's really cool to see. And this is like my fourth time doing Botox. It wears off every 3 to 4 months, and I have to be more on top of it, and that's my fault, you know. I need to start scheduling these things like ahead of time so that I'm on top of my Botox, so I do not get forehead wrinkles or any other like fine lines and wrinkles that might appear. So basically, man, you go up in there and you probably don't start to feel the effect of Botox till about like day two or three. That's when you start to feel heaviness in your brow. I remember driving and I was just like, dang, my brows just feel like they are just falling off of, like they're about to just droop down. Heaviness in the brow is a common side effect, and you're gonna feel that. And I feel like I feel it so much because my eyebrows are so expressive. Another thing too is that after I get Botox done, right, man, I feel like my eyebrows don't look as thin. And that's because like this muscle that like causes like an arch, like it gives the illusion that my eyebrows are like thinner than they are. So I like to like lower them down and give them more of a masculine look. And also, you guys know I get my eyebrows microbladed, and the biggest thing with that is just to create more balance in my eyebrows and symmetry. So the Botox really helps out with that, and I always feel like after I get Botox, my eyebrows look a lot thicker and fuller. And it helps out with that like a lot. So that's why I like Botox as well. Another thing too is that like your forehead gonna be shining, but like in a good way. Like it's just smooth, like there's no wrinkles. And last and final thing, man, on day seven, bro, like I don't know, it just feels nice to have. And like you see like the smooth, like your smooth forehead with no wrinkles, and you still have expression. Look at that. Like I have like full range of motion. You can tell when I'm angry at you. You can tell when I'm excited. You know, it just minimizes the movement, you know. So another thing that I want to touch upon too as well is that some people say like, oh, Botox is going to make your wrinkles look worse. Let me go ahead and bust that myth real quick. This is the reason why people think that Botox makes your wrinkles look worse. And it's because of your fucking egos. Like, it's because of your big egos. This is why. And I'm going to tell you this. It's because I actually did this too. Once the Botox wears off, and usually you don't think your forehead wrinkles look that bad. And it's because you have to live with them. And that's, you know, that's your brain trying to make you comfortable and trying to make you happy. You think that your wrinkles aren't that bad, but you can notice them. And maybe the doctor has said, oh, I think you need some Botox. I think that would help you out a little bit. And you're like, yeah, sure, why not? So you get the Botox and you love the results. Now, like I said, Botox is temporary. It wears off. Once it wears off and you've been looking at yourself, you know, in the mirror, like I said, you have that smooth forehead, there's no wrinkles. And then once it wears off, guess what? It goes back to where you were before. So it just goes back to what your wrinkles look like before. Your brain thinks in contrast. You don't see white until there's black. Like, if there was no white, there would be no black. Like, white is the presence of color, black is the absence of color, the yin and the yang. You like, your body thinks in contrast. You don't appreciate good until you've had bad. Like, there are so many things that you don't notice until there's the opposite there. So once the Botox wears off, and then you see what your forehead looked like before you had the Botox, it's like for some reason your brain thinks that it's worse because of what you, because you've had better. Do you know what I'm saying? If you don't know what I'm saying, I guess you're just fucking stupid. But but your mind thinks in contrast. Without the bad, there you wouldn't know what good is. You know what I'm saying? That's just how the human brain works. So no, Botox does not make your wrinkles worse. It does not cause other muscles to overcompensate or anything stupid like that. Botox literally prevents wrinkles, and it gets rid of wrinkles in some cases as well if it's not, you know, too far gone. But trying to tell you, Botox is probably like the best investment. And another thing too, I'm just gonna say it, all these anti-aging bullshit drugstore products, they're talking about, oh, get rid of your wrinkles, see wrinkle reduction in like 12 weeks. Stop it. Just stop letting these people sell you stuff. Like, this is the stuff that actually works and that actually has scientific evidence and research to back it up. As a human race, I don't think we'll ever, like, be able to just think for ourselves and just use our own brains. I don't ever think that's possible. But if you're watching this video, congratulations. You, sir or ma'am, are about to use your own brain and think for yourself and have some sense of discernment. Know what is bullshit, know what's real shit. Somebody will not spend $300 on forehead Botox because it's a lot of money. You know, I get it. It's a big investment. I get it. You have bills to pay. You have kids, whatever. I get it. Versus a $15 jar of anti-aging moisturizer that is supposed to promise you, like, you know, reduce wrinkles in 12 weeks, whatever. I get it. You want to spend a $15, but in all actuality, in the long run, is that anti-wrinkling cream gonna do anything? No, hell no. Just stop it. Just stop. It's marketing schemes. The real stuff that is gonna help you, which is, yes, Botox, which is demonized, which a lot of people are afraid of because, oh, if I tell somebody, like, I get Botox, I'm gonna get made fun of? What the fuck? Shut up, you fucking child. Like, if that shit is going to help you, if Botox is going to fucking help get rid of your wrinkles, and if wrinkles are a big insecurity of yours, get rid of it. Get rid of it, man. Like, spend the money, get rid of it. Like, this shit right here, Botox, hell of studies, hell of experiments, clinically safe studies, all that research. I'll even show you guys a picture of twins that one twin had Botox and the other one didn't get Botox, and I will show you the difference in quality of their skin. If that doesn't sell you on Botox, I don't know what will. And these twins weren't necessarily old. I think they were like in their 30s or 40s. But one of the twins got Botox and one of them didn't get Botox. You know, they do a comparison thing. Bro. Like, what? I'm not a Botox spokesperson. I don't sell Botox. I'm not trying to sell you anything. I'm just trying to, like, again, I'm just the dude. I'm just the good dude just trying to push you guys in the right direction. And just stop trying to make, literally, I don't want you to waste your money or your time. And you think that's contradicted because I'm telling you, like, to spend $300 versus $15, but literally you will waste spending your time and your money on a $15 anti-aging, anti-wrinkle creams versus just getting the fucking Botox. If you're somebody who's just like, I don't want people to know because you're a little bitch, then go ahead. You know, you don't have to tell anybody. I'm not saying to tell people your business. I don't care. As a matter of fact, nobody should really, like, care that fucking much. If you fucking look good, you fucking look good. No matter how you got there, you're good. You know what I'm saying? But some people, for some reason, just want to, like, people are just so wired to worship things and to worship people. Like niggas just want you to be sent from the fucking gods. You know what? I'm talking too much. That's it for this video, you guys. I'll see y'all in the next video. Peace.
What's good, man? Yeah, we live, baby. All right, so about to get in my car, about to go to Dr. Cato's office. I need to get Botox in my forehead because this shit is starting to get really bad, and I'm starting to see wrinkles come up again, and it's like the wrinkles always look worse than you thought that they did, because it's like now you see what your wrinkles look like before. I remember when I first went to him and his nurse was like, oh, you need to get preventative Botox like now, and I was just like, okay, you know, I was just like it's not that big of a deal. And then once I got it and once I saw the difference that the Botox made, I am like never going back, dude. Like, as in like I'm never going back to like not getting Botox, because I was just like, whoa, I never realized how crazy deep my forehead wrinkles were. Not like crazy deep, but I could definitely tell a difference now. And a difference is like really significant. This is like really bright. And the difference is crazy. So going there right now. And I think yesterday was like national Botox Day. November 15th was National Botox Day. Crazy, right? I think I'm gonna get a special on the Botox. I think it's $11 a unit today, which I believe in total I get about 30 units in my forehead, so including like this area and also the glabella area as well. So I'm driving right now, so I'll catch you guys up later. All right, y'all can see that's the before. And I'm just getting it right here. Well, you know, I'll show you guys immediately after.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, how are you?
Good, how so are you?
So
nice to
see you.
Nice to see you too. Thank you. So what are we here to do?
Yeah, Botox in the forehead and glabella, because mm-hmm. It's definitely worn away. I think it's been like 5 or 6 months.
Look at your
Yeah. It's strong.
So yeah. At some point we'll do it just to kind of get it, mm-hmm. to sharpen it a little bit.
Yeah.
I see.
I also feel like, I don't know if my chin's going back or not. Like maybe
just a little bit.
Yeah.
Not just a little bit of chin sharpen this at mm-hmm. some point. Maybe a tad bit here. But just kind of like update it.
Yeah. Okay.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Raise your eyebrows now.
I know.
A few minutes will go away.
Yeah.
It's usually like that.
Yeah.
the thinner the skin, the more you could see them.
Mm-hmm.
So, but give it like, you know, 3 to 10 days, and then you get so much better.
Yeah.
All right, bumps are starting to go away. Like you said, my skin is like very thin because I have like no body fat on my body. So still have movement, but you can still see like the injection sites. Literally bumps are going down. Like it hasn't even been 10 minutes yet and they're like not as intense as before. Honestly, they were kind of intense at first, I'm not gonna lie. But you can still kind of see them a little bit. Oh yeah, they're going down. Oh my god. At first when it popped up, I was like, oh my god. I don't know if I've ever seen them that like tall, but I still have movement. But we'll see by day 7, 10. Said it takes about 3 to 10 days to see a result. But usually it's been like 7 days, that's when I usually see it. You can see it's still right there. Try my best, like don't rub it, you know what I mean? Like don't do anything crazy. So yeah. So what I also got from Dr. Kato's office is some skincare. I got the Zoe Skin Health hydrating cream, and then I have the Zoe Skin Health pigment control and blending cream. The pigment control and blending cream has the 4% hydroquinone, which I mix with the tretinoin. Wow. Ooh, I gotta vacuum out my car anyways. This is what it looks like. You guys cannot see that because it is way too bright out here. But then also the hydrating cream. I've been out of this moisturizer for a while. This is like the best moisturizer in the game right now. The Zoe Skin Health Hydrating Cream. You guys cannot see the label, but if you guys have not seen my skincare routine video, go ahead and check that out for 2022. Honestly, I'm gonna apply this right now. Oh, I just got Botox, so let me not apply it to my forehead like a maniac. I'm just gonna apply it and the dry spots like around my mouth. As you guys know, my products have been drying me out. I just scheduled an appointment for my next laser hair removal and then my next appointment for a Dermalan peel. So yeah. Also, he always like assesses my skin and stuff like that. Still says continue on with the laser hair removal. And then, what else did he say? Oh, yeah, he said I need Botox and a masseter again because I have some really strong masseter muscles, and it'll help define my jaw a lot more. Also, some filler, like, in the at the ramus just to accentuate that and make the jawline pop out more. So, yeah. Honestly, I'm gonna wait till I stop like these products, the hydroquinone products, because I mean, like, you saw how like the Botox, like just like the bumps that like it gave me and like how high they were. Whenever I'm on these products, like I just like my skin just reacts crazy, like the yeah. it just swells, like, yeah. So, oh no. Yeah. Oh, God. God help me through this. God, just watch over me as I go through this process. Watch over me. And let everything go, you know. Just watch over me, God, as I go through all this and help me through this process. And help me get the results that I want, that are optimal. In your name I pray. Amen. I'm about to go to Ollie's. I'm about to go to Ollie's, to this discount store. and see if I can give me some storage containers. If you guys can't tell, I'm not really like high energy today because I've been up since 4 a.m. and it is now 11:30. I didn't weight lift today, but I went for an hour walk and I already have like 12,000 steps in. According to my watch, it's like 450 calories. I don't know if you guys can see it. Alrighty. So, yeah. Honestly, dude, like today, like I just want to like treat myself. Like I said, I just want to go to some stores, maybe like buy me a plant or something. And yeah, I'm off today. I might be off tomorrow. Might pick up overtime, but I've been working so much overtime. But honestly, you got to do things for your future self, because right now I thank myself so much for working that much overtime. But like, while I was working the overtime, dude, I was like, fuck this shit, man. I fucking hate this shit. But yeah, so just do things for your future self. Like right now I'm just thanking my past self for doing that. And you know, I was really like getting like in the mood. I was just like, man, should I pick up this overtime? Should I not pick up this overtime? And I'm glad that, you know, I did. And yeah, so I said, this is part of the process, getting the Botox, you know, getting in there. I'm tapping the area because it itches a little bit, but I'm not gonna be aggressive. I'm not like, I don't even want to touch the forehead, bro. Like, I just don't want to. Yeah, you guys already know. But this is part of the process, you know what I mean? Like, making these investments into yourself. That's what, man, that's what it's all about, bro. Just like, make the investments. Like, make the investments, make the investments. Like, you invest hundreds, you'll make back hundreds. You invest thousands, you'll make back thousands. You invest millions, you'll make back millions. Like, it's so difficult to like tell people like, yes, invest in yourself, because everybody thinks that the world owes them something. Everybody thinks that, like, you know, has this like fallacy or like this false premise that, like, you know, what you do, like, you shouldn't, you know, like, pay for anything. You know what I mean? Like, everything should be given to you, and like, you should just get. And it's just like, nah, you get what you give. And you know, you've got to put up some money, you know what I mean? So don't have this ego that like, oh, they should be paying me, or oh, everybody should be paying me, and like, you should be like, and it's just like, nah, dude, like, chill. Like, you really, really need to invest into yourself. You know what I'm saying? Like, what you give, you get. So invest in yourself, man. Make these investments. I am so glad too, because it had National Botox Day, dog. Got $100 off the Botox. So it was like a special. It was like $11 a unit that day. And got $100 off because I had 1,000 points on Ally, so it was only $230. So like, this Botox treatment was $230. Would have been $330. And so I think you'd get about like 30 to 40 units, so maybe like 33 units. Yeah, like 33 units I had.